Pledge of Allegiance and the singing of our national anthem.
To the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Stepped up to play the cello and violin.
help us to succeed. Now is the time to open up our wings, and I will never stop.
Great pleasure to welcome you to Morgan Park Academy's 146th commencement. Today, we honor the efforts and accomplishments of the graduates here before us. Together with their family and friends, we usher them into the next phases of their lives, and we recognize a class educated in the MPA tradition as independent thinkers and global leaders. As distinguished guests, as distinguished guests such as our leaders, we welcome Ms. Sumara Thompson-King, our commencement speaker, and to the Thrall family, who is here to accept the Richard L. Duchossois Integrity and Values Alumni Award on behalf of their late father, Mr. Jerome Thrall. Welcome to the MPA faculty and staff, our students, family and friends, and to our trustees. But most of all, welcome to the class of 2019. We have long anticipated this day, some with eagerness, some with anxiety, and some with a complicated mix of emotions. But whatever you are feeling here today, you deserve to hold a keen sense of pride. You all have made it. I am so very proud of the class of 2019 for not only reaching their individual goals, but for always finding ways to help others along the way. They have had no better example than in Ms. Sue Oskowski, who is retiring from our faculty today. For the past 44 years, Coach O has modeled selflessness and caring for generations of MPA students, helping to make our school what it is today. Yet, I would say to our graduates that for all they have accomplished to this point, your job doesn't end today. As you embark on your collegiate lives, please remember what it means to give back. Remember Coach O, her dedication to the MPA community. Remember the parents and teachers who helped you along this journey and who contributed so widely to your experience here. You could also remember one of my favorite Maya Angelou quotes, "When we give cheerfully and accept gratefully, everyone is blessed." We all see that in practice every day at MPA, and I encourage you to carry that lesson forward with you as our newly minted independent thinkers and global leaders. Morgan Park Academy's highest award for alumni is the Richard L. Duchossois Integrity and Values Alumni Award. Given annually in recognition of Mr. Duchossois's lifetime achievements, outstanding professional success, and service to the Academy, his community, and society. Mr. Duchossois's example of accomplishments and service has for decades inspired classmates and colleagues, and has inspired all of us here at Morgan Park Academy to ensure that his beloved alma mater stays true to the mission and values that have guided us for nearly a century and a half. Today's recipient of the Duchossois Award is Mr. Jerome Thrall of the class of 1934. Mr. Thrall was founder and chairman of Thrall Enterprises in Chicago, and for many years, he was executive vice president of Thrall Car Manufacturing Company. A U.S. Navy veteran and devoted family man, he counted the Academy among many community and civic organizations that he supported generously. Mr. Thrall was inducted into the MPA Hall of Fame in 1997, and since his passing in 2009, his family has continued that commitment to his alma mater, creating a scholarship fund to outstanding rising students and making possible our new makerspace for collaborative and hands-on learning, building and designing. Here to accept the Duchossois Integrity and Values Alumni Award is Mr. Thrall, Jeff Thrawson, Jerome Thrawson.
Thanks, Mercedes, for the kind remarks, and also thank you to you and your team for organizing such a great day of weather here for us today. So, beautiful day. So on behalf of the Thrall family, I'd like to thank the board for selecting Dad as the recipient of the Richard Duchossois Award. Dad would be very proud if he were here today. He loved Morgan Park, or the Academy, as he would call it. And his education and experience here helped prepare him for a successful business career, more importantly for him, to raise a family that would ultimately grow to 6 children and 14 grandchildren. Morgan Park provided the foundation for the family values he instilled on us and we share with our children. It also provided the foundation for a successful business career. Dick Duchossois is Dad's brother-in-law, and together they ran Thrall Car, our family business at the time, which was founded by our grandfather. Morgan Park Academy was a military academy when Dad was here, and cadets would march in the area we're seated in today. We love looking at old photographs of Dad in uniform from his high school days, He was active in athletics, lettering in basketball and football multiple times, and always promoted lifelong friendships. He had lifelong friendships with classmates that were created here, and we're fortunate to know some of Dad's closest high school friends. Bud Hall, Mel Bacon, Howard Stason are a few I remember, and they became Uncle Bud, Uncle Mel, and Uncle Stace for us as we were growing up. Dad met our mom when he went to Morgan Park, and they started dating shortly after he graduated in 1944. The world was a much different place back then, and World War II pulled Dad into military service in the Navy. Again, he was well prepared because it was a Morgan Park experience. Of course, that experience included some pranks, and here's one I'll share with you today. There were streetcars on 111th Street at that time, and Dad and some friends would grease the rails to make it hard for the streetcars to get up the hill on 111th. I'm sure that was only one of many that he shared with us. Hopefully all the graduates today will look back on their Morgan Park Academy experience and feel as good about it and value it as much as Dad did. Before ending, since this is a commencement event, it was suggested that I share some words of wisdom with the graduates. Since I've never given a commencement speech before, like all good students today, I relied on the internet for some ideas and ran across an article written by Mary Schmick, a Pulitzer Prize winning author and columnist for the Chicago Tribune. Some of you may have heard this before, but I think her comments are certainly very relevant today. And they were actually written in the late 90s when my daughter graduated from high school and was a hot topic back then. But this was obviously before many of the graduates, well, all the graduates were born. So she called this her guide to life for graduates. And it starts with a very appropriate piece of advice for today. Wear sunscreen. If I could offer only one tip for the future, sunscreen would be it. The long-term benefits of sunscreen have been proven by scientists, whereas most of my advice has no basis more reliable than my own meandering experience, but I will dispense that advice now. Enjoy the power and beauty of your youth. Oh, never mind. You'll never understand the power and beauty of your youth until it's faded. But trust me, in 20 years, you'll look back at photos of yourself and recall the way, in a way you can't grasp today, how much possibility lay before you and how fabulous you really looked. You're not as fat as you imagine. Don't worry about the future, or worry, but know that worrying is as effective as trying to solve a calculus problem by chewing bubble gum. The real troubles in your life are apt to be things that never crossed your worried mind, the kind that blindside you at 4 p.m. on some idle Tuesday. Do one thing every day that scares you. Sing. Don't be reckless with other people's hearts. Don't put up with people who are reckless with yours. Floss. Don't waste your time on jealousy. Sometimes you're ahead, sometimes you're behind. The race is long, and in the end, it's only with yourself. Remember compliments you receive. Forget the insults. If you succeed in doing this, please tell me how. Keep your old love letters. Throw away your old bank statements. Stretch. Don't feel guilty if you don't know what to do with your life. The most interesting people I know didn't know at your age what they wanted to do with their lives. Some of the most interesting 40-year-olds I know still don't. Get plenty of calcium, be kind to your knees, you'll miss them when they're gone. Maybe you'll marry, maybe you won't, maybe you'll have children, maybe you won't. Maybe you'll divorce at 40, maybe you'll dance the funky chicken at your 75th wedding anniversary. Whatever you do, don't congratulate yourself too much or berate yourself either. Your choices are half chance, so are everybody else's. Know your body. Use it in every way you can. Don't be afraid of it or what other people think of it. It's the greatest instrument you'll ever own. Dance, even if you have nowhere to do it but in your living room. Read the directions, even if you don't follow them. Do not read beauty magazines that only make you feel ugly. Get to know your parents. You'll never know when they'll be gone for good. Be nice to your siblings. They're your best link to the past and the people most likely to stick with you in the future. Understand that friends come and go, but with a precious few you should hold on. Work hard to bridge the gaps in geography and lifestyle, because the older you get, the more you'll need the people who knew you when you were young. Live in New York City once, but leave before it makes you hard. Live in Northern California once, but leave before it makes you soft. travel. Accept certain inalienable truths. Life, prices will rise, politicians will philander. You too will get old, and when you do, you'll fantasize that when you were young, prices were reasonable, politicians were noble. Most people might agree with that today. And children respected their elders. Respect your elders. Don't expect anyone else to support you. Maybe you'll have a trust fund, maybe you'll have a wealthy spouse, but you never know when either one might run out. Be careful whose advice you buy, but be patient with those who supply it. Advice is a form of nostalgia. Dispensing it is a way of fishing the past from the disposal, wiping it off, painting over the ugly parts, and recycling it for more than it's worth. And trust me on the sunscreen. So a few more words here in closing. Believe in yourself, and this is for the graduates, and all of us really for that matter. Trust your gut, take calculated risks. Be different, stay humble, learn from other people, learn other people's names, follow your dreams, but most importantly, have fun. Congratulations and all the best for the class of 2019. Thank you.
Thank you to the Thrall family. It is now my privilege to welcome Sumara Thompson-King to deliver our commencement address. After graduating from Morgan Park Academy in 1976, Ms. Thompson-King earned a BA in government at Smith College and a JD from Georgetown University Law Center. Since 2014, she has been general counsel at Nassau, serving as the agency's chief legal officer and overseeing its team of attorneys responsible for all aspects of Nassau's legal affairs around the world. Ms. Thompson-King is a frequent panelist and a speaker on legal matters related to government and commercial space activities, and has received Meritorious Presidential Rank Award, Nassau's Outstanding Leadership Medal, and Nassau's Exceptional Achievement Medal in recognition of her legal achievements. Please help me welcome Sumara Thompson-King.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Yeah, that's a Morgan Park Academy good morning. It is a good morning. We're all gathered here today to celebrate the graduation of the Morgan Park Academy class of 2019. Let's give them a round of applause. It is truly my joy and my honor to have been invited to give this commencement address, and I am a proud member of the Morgan Park Academy class of 1976. Thank you, head of school. Thank you, trustees, the head of the board of trustees, and all the trustees who are here for this very great honor. Graduates, this graduation ceremony gives those of us present the opportunity to acknowledge the completion of your secondary education, recognizing that your time here at MPA is just one part of your journey. And what an important part of your life has been and will continue to be your MPA journey. It was difficult for me to come up with a theme or a topic for this speech today. And being a lawyer, I have to adjust. So I'm going to adjust my speech a little bit cover a few points, reduce a few points that I had planned to talk about. I had to think about topics that were interesting to you, and really I hope you will remember some things that you heard from Mr. Thrall and also that I'm going to share with you. So we'll see how this goes. So I took my inspiration for today's remarks from the Morgan Park Academy website, where several students have shared their individual MPA journeys. My 6-year MPA journey influenced my education, my career, my family, my character, and my personal values. What I know now that I did not know on my MPA graduation day was how well this institution prepared me for the journey that followed. So like Mr. Thrall mentioned about his father, MPA prepared me well for the journey that I would take once I departed this campus. Today I really want to focus on just six lessons that I want to share with you that I've learned and that have been beneficial to me along the way. And some of these are things you've heard, but I want to share with you my personal experience in understanding them and learning about them. So the first one is, no one does it alone. No one does it alone. Your MPA journey has been nurtured by parents, your siblings, yeah, they do some nurturing too, relatives, friends, and other family members. You've been inspired and guided by the dedicated faculty and administrators of this academy, ably led by the head of school, Mrs. Shepherd. You've been enabled by the vision and the resources provided by the steady hands of a board of trustees, chaired by Mrs. Nichols. You've been supported by the commitment of alumni and other benefactors that have ensured the endurance of a challenging education program that encouraged creative thinking, intellectual growth, community service, global studies, and artistic and athletic enrichment. Likewise, my MPA journey had substantially similar support. In particular, I'm honored to have with me today my mother, Juanita Thompson, a retired teacher who taught in both the Chicago and New York City public school systems, and was the force in our family who ensured that my sister and I were educated at MPA. Our families ensure that we are not alone. Of course, there are difficult days in our family relationships. Yet these are also days when our family members are the only people who we can turn to and rely upon. So graduates, stay close to your family. They can be the fortress and the shield you need as you move through college, as you fall in and out of love, as you experience success or failure in your careers and in your financial circumstances. Speaking of failure leads me to talk to you about my second lesson learned. And it's an expression that I never used to understand, but it's nothing beats a failure but a try. And so what does that mean? It's real simple. When you fail, try again. Persevere. While a student at MPA, I was not an athletic superstar at all. So in those days, the girls' basketball team had to wear skirts. We did not play basketball in shorts. I was so bad that they did let me on the team because there was inclusiveness at that time. But I had to get my own red skirt. So I was not very good. I was the last person selected to be on the basketball team, but they let me join them. I tried volleyball after that. I jammed my thumb, couldn't play volleyball. So I kind of gave up sports. And the coaches were encouraging, but didn't see much athletic talent here. So in my senior year, we had a new coach come to the school. And in that senior year, there weren't many girls who were interested in playing field hockey. I had never played field hockey. But my senior year, they were desperate. So they recruited me. A friend of mine was playing the fullback position. They needed two halfbacks. So my best friend, Lisa Rubel, became one of the halfbacks. They asked me to try out for it. Who knew that I was going to love being a halfback? I didn't have to run the field I as much as others did, and I could take that stick and whack that ball and scare people. It was great. I didn't realize how great our team was going to be and what success we were going to have. And so in that first year that Coach Susan Oskowski was here, we beat North Shore Country Day. It was the first time we had ever beaten them. So I kept trying. I kept trying. And it was my friends here who encouraged me to keep trying to do something different. And in that last year, I found success in being on the field hockey team. And I was honored to have Coach O be one of those coaches who began her 44-year career of teaching and coaching at the Academy. And I know the Academy is going to greatly miss her because she was here encouraging students to persevere in both their athletic, artistic, and academic endeavors. So congratulations to you, Coach O. Another time that I faced a challenge and I needed to try again, and I reached back to what I had been doing when I was here in high school and in college, was when I did not pass the bar exam. So this is a story that I share with many students in law school and folks who are looking to fulfill their dreams. So Maya, that was a lovely song about dreaming, about never stop trying to be heard and keep your dreams going. That means you have to keep trying. So I graduated from law school and took the bar exam because all lawyers must pass a bar exam. I failed not once, but twice. I graduated from Morgan Park Academy. I graduated from Smith College. I graduated from the Georgetown University Law Center. How could I not pass the first, and oh my goodness, the second time? And this is where your family comes into play. I was embarrassed to tell my mother. I was embarrassed to tell my father. But my parents knew me, and they encouraged me to keep going. That was just a setback. It was temporary. You would succeed. So I took it the third time. And when I took the exam the third time, I scored so high that they did not have to read the essays, because a bar exam is a multiple choice exam and then essays. So I kept trying, and it was with the faith of my family and the perseverance that I learned while I was here that I kept going. So dream big and keep going. Persevere. Related to that is a third lesson I've learned, which is to dare mighty things. President Theodore Roosevelt, many people don't realize, he won the 1906 Nobel Prize. And his closing paragraph of his acceptance speech starts this way: "Far better it is to dare mighty things, to win glorious triumphs, even through checkered by failure, than to rank with those poor spirits who never enjoy nor suffer much, because they live in the gray twilight of that knows not victory nor defeat." So I encourage you, class of 2019, to dare mighty things. Dare mighty things doesn't necessarily mean building a rocket like the scientists and engineers do at NASA. And yes, we are in the business of building a rocket that's going to take us to the moon and establish a base there. That's a mighty thing to do. But it's also a mighty thing to do that's to decide to do something that's contrary to the guidance of your parents. My daughter, my youngest daughter, is with me today, and she was somebody who dared mighty things. She dared to be a teacher. If you know my daughter Camille, she loves fine things. And we had long talks about what her career choices were going to be. And of course, mother knew best. But Camille persevered, and she did what she wanted to do. But it also took a challenge to look me in the eye and tell me that she was going to teach. And what a great teacher she is, following in my mother's path. So sometimes parents aren't always right. Most of the time we are. But sometimes it means choosing a path, doing things that reflect what you want to do. Your parents will always love you. Young women, let me speak to you. Most men know how to do this, but as you leave the academy, go to college, go on into the workforce, ask for what you deserve. Seek the salary you deserve. Seek the job that you deserve. Stop thinking that you're not good enough for the position. you are, you're better. Seek out those challenges, dare yourself. And so what if it doesn't work out when you apply for that job and get it? Guess what? Try again. Move to another job. But be daring. Use your talents. You have them. You will be successful. There might be a failure, but you will succeed in the end. Fourth lesson, be kind to yourself and to others. Continue that community service endeavor that you engaged in here at Morgan Park Academy, and also practice random acts of kindness. Those random acts of kindness will never be worthless. They may strengthen you and sustain you more than the beneficiary of your kindness. A fifth lesson that we don't talk about much, but I'm glad I heard it today. It's to be a good citizen of the United States of America. Why is that important? Because it is our responsibility as citizens of this great country to ensure the longevity, growth, and vitality of our democracy. It will not continue if we merely sit on our hands and wait for others to do it. So it is important to be citizens. It's important to vote. It's important to do what my older daughter started doing in her new hometown, which is to register people to vote. It is important to sit on parent-teacher association boards. It's important to groom yourself to be on a board of trustees of an independent coeducational school in the city of Chicago. Citizenship is something we do not talk about enough. It's something I hope that when you go to college, you will be on your student government associations there, you will join organizations that promote community service, and you will be respectful of the people who serve this country and protect us every day who are in our military. Because this institution started as a military academy, and many of the traditions that we still hold to relate back to that educational institution and the values that it instilled in its students, like Mr. Thrall, and continues to instill in the students who are here today and who are going to be recipients of the Jerome Thrall Jr. Leadership Award, which acknowledges faithfulness to the MPA tradition of excellence in citizenship. And the last thing I'll recommend to you is the beginning line of a song that they always sang at my college graduation, "Gaudiamus Igitur." And those words mean, "Let us rejoice." So in that song, the final two passages say, "Long live the academy, long live the professors, long live each student, long live the whole fraternity. Forever may they flourish. May our alma mater thrive, a font of education, friends, colleagues, wherever they are, whether near or far, heed her invitation. So stay close to your families, class of 2019. Stay close to the Morgan Park Academy that has created the journey that you are traveling on. Continue to stay close to your friends, develop new friends, and be joyful in everything you do." And I end with a prayer that I say to myself, "This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it." And so, class of 2019, be glad today. Congratulations.
Thank you so much, Samira. And now for a few awards, starting with the House Cup. Like many schools throughout the world, Morgan Park Academy divides all of its students, faculty, and staff into five houses. Named for five giants of MPA history, they are Blake House, Malcolm House, Norton, Theodore, and Withington House. The house system provides a framework for intramural, athletic, charity, fundraising, and community competitions. Students win points for participation in all facets of school life, including academic achievement, co-curricular involvement, good deeds, and volunteer work. At the end of the year, the house with the most points wins the cup. This year's winner, for the second year in a row, is Malcolm House. Here to accept the cup is Malcolm House Captain Maya Lopez. The school year's honor and high honor rolls include nearly all of our graduating seniors who continued their academic excellence all the way through the end of the year. Certificates for our other upper school students will be sent home. On the honor roll are students who earn a grade point average of at least 3.3 in all major subjects. Honorees for the school year include one graduating senior, Maurice Jenkins. On the high honor roll for the school year are students who have earned a grade point average of at least 3.7 in all major subjects. The class of 2019 is well represented. As I call your name, please stand. Hallie Berghoff, Angela Cabrera, Murphy Chen, Brian Coronado, Ethan Dung, Jillian Dunlap, Zara Hashmi, Connor Hugh, Ethan Jajorian, Ireland Lawrence, Maya Lopez, Amaya McLaughlin, Elijah Moss, Timothy Rooney, Emmanuel Sarpong, Tony Tang, and Will Way. William Zhang, Juliana Zygmunt, and Jimena Zuleta. Now, overall academic distinction prizes go to the students in each upper school class with the highest academic average for the school year. Their names are placed on the honor plaque hanging in Alumni Hall. This year's freshman winner is Manav Pasta, the sophomore class, Emmett Campbell, in the junior class, Jason Chen, and in our senior class, Angela Cabrera. We also surveyed the upper school as a whole for three scholar awards in the form of gold, silver, and bronze medals given to students with the highest academic average in the upper school. This year, the three highest averages all belong to members of this senior class. The bronze medal goes to Zara Hashmi. The silver medal goes to Maya Lopez. And the gold medal goes to Angela Cabrera. The Jerome Thrall Junior Leadership Award is the most prestigious award given to the students at the end of their junior year. It rewards faithfulness to the NPA tradition of excellence in citizenship, superior scholarship, and dedication to the enhancement of the common good. Recipients are chosen by the upper school faculty and receive a $4,000 scholarship for their senior year at the academy. Here today to join me in presenting this award are two of Mr. Thrall's grandchildren, Lindsay and Danny. This year's first recipient of the Thrall Award is D'Angelo Fletcher, a student at MPA since the fifth grade. D'Angelo is a high honor roll student who has made his mark on our school in a variety of ways. He is an advanced Mandarin student earning membership in the National Chinese Honor Society. He has been a fixture on stage within our choral groups and our theater production. And on the tennis courts, he has twice qualified for the state tournament, both in singles and doubles. D'Angelo. Our second recipient is Sumara Harris. Samaria Harris. Here with us since her days as a lower school student, she is a member of the National Honor Society, the girls' volleyball and basketball teams, the Honor Council, Service Council, Diversity Council, and our Dance for Life productions. She is a well-rounded student who is successful in the classroom and through many areas of student life on campus, displaying leadership, a passion for learning, and a willingness to help her fellow students. Congratulations to both the recipients. To graduate with cum laude distinction, student must be ranked in the top 20% of the graduating class, with an especially tough achievement this year with such a small class. Students in the Cum Laude Society receive pins and certificates and are wearing gold caps today to signify their membership. This year's cum laude graduates are Angela Carrera, Murphy Chen, Zara Hashi, Maya Lopez, and William Wei. At the Academy, we take the study of international affairs seriously. It is a huge part of who we are and what makes us unique. Project Week, service, the exchange program, our classes, and our faculty, the study of Spanish, French, Mandarin, beginning at the lower school, are all key components of the MPA experience. Today, we recognize two of our graduating seniors for their dedication to global citizenship with the Global Scholars Award. Our first recipient has embraced global learning since her days in the lower school. She has studied French now up to the college level, earning membership in the French Honor Society, having traveled to South Korea and to the Bahamas during Project Week. A longtime member of the Diversity Council, she has represented her Filipino culture and has helped promote international cultures at school events throughout her time here. This year, her senior capstone project raised funds for a missionary group in the Philippines that provides sanctuary for victims of human trafficking and child prostitution. Our first recipient is Angela Cabrera. Our second recipient of the Global Scholars Award is a young man who has embodied the cross-cultural experience of our international students. In addition to his leadership efforts with the Diversity Council, he was elected to the Student Council and led a buddy program that helped international students acclimate more comfortably to life here in Chicago. His decision to stay here for college, and even more important, his success in figuring out how to navigate Lower Wacker Drive, shows how much he has embraced his new home city and model what it means to learn globally at Morgan Park Academy. Our second recipient is Connor Hill. Martin J. Wolf Service Award is presented to the senior with the most outstanding record of service to the school and the community as selected by the Service Club advisors. Recipients' names are engraved on a plaque to be displayed in Hanson Hall. The award is named for Martin Wolf, the Academy's longtime director of service learning. This senior class has an especially impressive record of service, with more than 3,000 service hours logged in the past 4 years. That's an average of more than 130 hours per student. This year's winner of the Service Award logged a full 313 service hours. She volunteered at the Shedd Aquarium, at the Brookfield Zoo, at a youth and nature camp, and also served on the team board of the Ronald McDonald House. On campus, she always looks for ways to improve her community and provide better opportunity for MPA students of all ages. This year's winner is Maya Lopez. The Jean Landon Taylor Alumni Award is presented each year on behalf of the Alumni Association. A bronze plaque goes to a senior scholar in recognition of academic achievement, citizenship, and participation in school activities as determined by a vote of the upper school faculty. The award is named in honor of Jean Landon Taylor, who served as an instructor of English and head of the English department at Morgan Park Military Academy from 1929 to 1945. This year's award goes to Murphy Chen. The scholarship award is presented each year to a senior scholar in recognition of scholastic excellence, citizenship, and participation in school activities. It's chosen by a vote of the upper school faculty and comes with a bronze plaque. This year's award goes to Zara Hashmi. The Harry D. Abels Award is presented annually to the class salutatorian based on 4-year cumulative grade point average. The winner receives a United States flag and a silver plaque. The award is named after Colonel Harry Delmont Abels, who joined the faculty of Morgan Park Academy in 1898 under Headmaster William Rainey Harper. Colonel Abels taught chemistry and physics and was instrumental in the reorganization of the school in 1914. He served officially as superintendent of Morgan Park Military Academy from 1917 until his retirement in 1945. This year's winner is Maya Lopez. Finally, the Hayden E. Jones Cup is presented annually to the class valedictorian as determined by the administration based on the 4-year cumulative grade point average. To be eligible, a student must have attended the academy for at least 3 years, including 11th and 12th grades. The winner receives a gold plaque and has his or her name inscribed on the cup. Its namesake, Lieutenant Colonel Hayden Jones, joined the faculty of Morgan Park Academy as an instructor in Latin and history in 1899 while the academy was still part of the University of Chicago. In 1907, as we separated from the university, he joined Colonel Abels in reorganizing the school as Morgan Park Academy. And from 1919 until 1946, he served as superintendent. This beautiful quad was named in his honor in 1937, along with this top student award. This year, the award goes to Angela Cabrera. Angela is going to put down her plaque because she's now going to give her valedictory address.
Giving us this wonderful day. As Mr. Malcolm would say, it's a wonderful day at the Academy. It is an incredible honor to have the opportunity to speak in front of you all and celebrate Morgan Park Academy's graduating class of 2019. Thank you all for coming. One may think that it would be easier for someone who attended the same school for 15 years to write such a speech. Despite being on stage many times, this speech has been by far the most nerve-wracking thing I have ever had to do, because I could not find the perfect way to capture the epitome of our high school experience. There are so many memories, people, and places that are all incredibly significant to our high school careers that it is simply impossible to fit them all in a single speech. So, naturally, instead of actually sitting down and writing this speech, I went on my phone and watched YouTube. The following information gave me the idea. In 1977, NASA launched both Voyager 1 and 2, which contained a 12-inch gold-plated copper disc known as the Golden Record. On this disc, there are carefully selected sounds of the world, ranging from the sounds of rain and crickets during the nighttime, to music by Bach and Beethoven. There are images of wildlife, people, and objects familiar to all of us on Earth. The Golden Record was made to represent our planet, our home, so that one day when it is discovered, anyone or anything who has obtained it will then have a pretty good guess of what our world is like. At this moment, however, Voyager 1 and 2, along with the Golden Record, are still drifting aimlessly in outer space. Now, you may be thinking, how on earth is she going to make a connection between space and school? This is an odd opening for a valedictory speech. However, I made the connection that this speech is similar to the purpose of the Golden Record, except with the purpose of providing a summary of our 4 years of high school, and instead of some extraterrestrial being hearing it, you all are. Of course, a reflection of 4 years of high school, of a high school class, cannot possibly compare to a reflection of the magnitude of human nature, but it's still pretty challenging. I decided that the absolute best way of describing our class, and essentially Morgan Park Academy, is to call it a family. There is really no other way I could describe it, and I can assure you that not many high schools can feel that way. Being such a small school allows us to make unforgettable memories with both classmates and teachers, and create relationships that would last a lifetime. Whether you are here for 1 year or 15 years, you are always a part of this family and its love and support. This school has undoubtedly shaped each and every one of us to be the amazing individuals we are today, and for that, we are truly grateful. If you started at Morgan Park Academy as a preschooler, your teacher would teach you the most important, most essential phrase you would need to get through life and become a good person. Be kind and do your best. If Morgan Park Academy had its own Golden Record, this would be its title. Be kind and do your best. These words stuck in my head during my whole time here at MPA, and even though many of us here on stage have attended this school only for a few years, I can honestly say that each of us has exemplified this short, yet incredibly meaningful phrase, in addition to being some of the most compassionate, helpful, and supportive individuals I have ever met. They are all incredibly talented and successful in academics and various passions. Among us are the doctors, actors, and actresses, music producers, engineers, teachers, businessmen and women, environmentalists, and advocates of the future. Being one of the smallest graduating classes, with a whopping total of 23 students, it was a blessing to have the opportunity to spend so much time with my second family. The incredible diversity of cultures, backgrounds, and passions of this class have made a lasting impact on this school and its future. They continue to inspire me, and with whatever they do, and I am confident that wherever they are and whenever, each of them will succeed in pursuing their own passions and make the world a better place. Our teachers, staff, and administration are our second parents away from home, and words cannot describe how thankful we are to have them in our lives. As upper school students, we have had opportunities to work with administration and staff for school events and occasions. I would like to especially thank Mrs. Drown, Mr. Durhazel, Mrs. Shepherd, and Mr. Hermosilla for greatly helping us in student council and for all that you do to make Morgan Park Academy the great school it is today. Thank you, Ms. Yvonne, Mrs. Williams, and Ms. Alley for always greeting everyone with a smile. And thank you, Ms. Beata and Ms. V for making our campus gorgeous each day. We all appreciate everything you do for our school. Because of your hard work and dedication, we are all here today. Every teacher at Morgan Park Academy, whether they teach lower, middle, or upper school, has a genuine, real love for their students and will do anything it takes for them to succeed, not only academically, but as a good person. They have raised us to be globally aware, to approach life with an open mind, and to not be afraid to challenge our own ideas. In addition to learning course material, we would often have class talks about the future, how we were mentally, and how we felt about graduating this year. Each teacher has given us advice and support that we will carry with us as we move on to college, and they will always be there for us whenever we may need. They have helped us especially when times are difficult, whether it is a challenging math problem in AP Calculus, thank you, Mr. Gaiman, translations in French, merci, madame, a 30-page paper in AP Comparative Government and Politics, thank you, Mrs. Fahey, or an AP Literature essay that we procrastinated on and had Ms. Concannon, one of the most understanding teachers I have ever known, give us an extension. Thank you, Ms. Concannon. I would also like to thank Coach O, who is leaving Morgan Park Academy this year for all that she has done during her many years of teaching physical education here. She was one of the many teachers, if not the best one, who stressed the importance of the MPA way, be kind and do your best, and not only gym class, but in everything we do. This year, there was one moment in particular that showed me how incredibly blessed I am to have such caring and loving teachers. The day we arrived back from our South Korea Global Learners trip this year was also the day when many college decisions were released. I am positive that everyone here, graduating here today, and even all of you, can agree that rejection is hard. When receiving a rejection letter from my dream school, I will admit, I was devastated and started crying in customs. It was kind of weird. The college process is undoubtedly stressful, and everyone here would agree. As we were picking up our bags from the baggage claim, Miss Yoon saw that I was upset and approached me. She thought that I was so incredibly sad that we had to come back to America after 1 week of being in South Korea, and comforted me. After I told her about my college rejection, she gave me a hug and said, "Everything will be okay." And that stuck with me. Thank you, Ms. Yoon. And thank you to all of the teachers. With your love and support, everything will be okay, despite any struggles or challenges we may face in our journey. Our senior class would like to especially thank our advisors, Ms. Concannon, Ms. McAllister, and Mrs. Drown, for taking care of us during our 4 years of high school. You have done so much for our class by being our mentors and friends, for ensuring that our senior year especially was memorable, and for making sure that we all graduate. Thank you. These types of personal relationships with teachers seldom occur in high schools, especially much larger ones, which is why I, and all of the graduates, are thankful to have such wonderful people to keep in touch with in the future. To our parents and siblings, we really cannot thank you enough for the love that you have for us, for the sacrifices you have made for us to be here in front of you, and for your endless support. I would like to thank my own parents, who immigrated to the United States from the Philippines, having to leave both family and friends in order to start a new life. Having to leave both family and friends in order to start a new life of opportunities for Andrew and I. Oh, sorry. I'm like ugly crying. Thank you, Papa, for working incredibly hard to support my education. And thank you, Mama, for teaching me to trust in God and live in the present moment. And thank you, Andrew, for always studying next to me and being my biggest fan. Okay, it's like the hard part. Our families are the ones who have set us on the path to this journey of high school, and you will continue to guide us in all of our future endeavors. The lessons, morals, and beliefs that you have taught us throughout the years have been ingrained in our memory, and they will stay there for a lifetime. So, graduates of Morgan Park Academy, the day that we have been working towards ever since the first time we set foot on campus, all the blood, sweat, and tears have finally paid off, and it's time to move on to our next journey. This is only the beginning. However, as we leave high school, I am sure that the memories and experiences that we have all had will stay with us for a good while, as they have led us to be the people we are today. Don't take pictures of me, I'm crying. I'd like to thank... Sorry. I'd like to think that each of us, not only the graduates, has our own imaginary golden record playing inside of our heads, filled with experiences that have shaped our identities. Whether they are good or bad, they are the memories that have created our beliefs, our personalities, and our passions. As we all travel into the unknown, or into our college careers, our pasts that have shaped us will be the basis on how we approach life. Be kind to others and do our best. I'm certain that Morgan Park Academy is a part of all of our golden records. Congratulations, class of 2019. We were born to make history. Thank you for being a part of mine. Thank you.
So, now for the moment we've been waiting for. Graduates, as graduates come forward, they will receive their diplomas from Ms. Eccles, our board president, a congratulations from Mr. Duchossois, our upper school principal. And memorable actress to see perform on stage, especially during the musicals, and she is capable of portraying all different types of characters. With her strong moral compass, she is never afraid to voice her opinion, and yet always treats others with kindness and respect. Hallie's ability to get along with everyone in any circumstance and natural tendency to lend a helping hand is remarkable. We can't wait to see her on Broadway one day. She plans to study acting at Illinois Wesleyan University, Hallie Burgoff. A student at NPA since pre-K, Angela embodies qualities like kindness, selflessness, and caring. As one classmate put it, she is literally liked by everyone. Angela excels in just about anything she tries and never gives up when something is challenging. She is well-rounded and humbled and has the compassionate ability to overlook others' weaknesses. We will miss her involvement in literally every aspect of student life, from student council to her memorable character portrayals in the stage. She plans to study biology at the University of Illinois at Urbana. Angela Beatrice Bonnell Cabrera. Although she might seem quiet in class, the louder side of Murphy's personality shines through when she is on stage, sharing her love of K-pop and her great choreography and dance moves. She is outgoing and funny and proud to share her Chinese culture with everyone at school. Always a hard worker, she is an extremely positive influence on her classmates and younger peers. Not only on the girls' basketball team, but on the stage, in the classroom, and throughout everyday campus life. She plans to study at the University of Waterloo, Murphy Chitman. Described by his classmates as a genius with technology and math, it is rare to find Brian without a laptop or other digital device in his hand. Brian is hardworking and determined, and as one of his peers put it, I have no doubt that he will be the next Thomas Edison with his skills in technology and gadgets. A state-level competitor with the ICTM and academic challenge teams, Brian regularly demonstrates his passion for understanding how things work. He is unconventionally intellectual and has such a kind soul, always making himself available to help with computer questions and problems for anyone on campus. He plans to study computer science at Drake University. Brian Coronado. As a member of the ICTM and Academic Challenge teams, Ethan has definitively left his mark, succeeding at the state level in physics and engineering graphics. He is eager to learn, widely admired for his math skills, and recognized by his classmates as consistently insightful. He has a talent for mobile gaming and livens up any conversation with his quiet humor. He plans to study business at Carnegie Mellon University, Zixuan Duan. Although it may seem as if she is always a quiet, independent spirit, when you see her on stage, you are treated to a whole new Jillian. As you get to know her, this side shines through with her bubbly talk of societal issues and the newest Broadway shows. Jillian is musical, artistic, driven, hardworking, and in possession of a dark sense of humor. Quick to memorize and learn songs and dialogue with ease, she brings a matter-of-fact attitude that is helpful in class discussions and giving thoughtful support and guidance to her friends. She plans to study psychology at the Eugene Lang College of Liberal Arts at the New School. Jillian Iman Dunlap. Described accurately by her classmates as a go-getter, Zara has been heavily involved in student life throughout her 8 years at MPA. One of her biggest contributions has been her tireless work with student council throughout her high school career. She was always trying to find ways to make the student experience better. Zara has always challenged herself with her course load and worked hard to do her best. She is very goal-oriented, and her pursuit to become an eye surgeon is remarkable, taking her through numerous service trips and countless volunteer hours at the hospital. Her classmates find her supportive, a natural leader, and a social media expert. She always makes a point to include everyone in everything. I will personally miss hearing her music on 112th Street in front of my home. She plans to study biology at the University of Michigan, Zara Hashmi. first surprising many of us with his rap skills when he was a sophomore, Connor has an enthusiasm, an independence of thought, and a unique hairstyle that earned him this year's We'll Never Forget You Award. Connor is known for his passion for filming and editing videos, being a DJ of dances, and drinking so much coffee that we say he is powered by espresso. He has a great sense of humor and seems to always find reserves of energy, even when he's burning the candle at both ends. Truly his own person, Connor is excellent at viewing things from a global perspective. He plans to study filmmaking at Columbia College. Connor Hugh. We will always remember Reese for his smile, which can light up a room, and his ability to find humor in everything. Reese has been an influential member of the Business Professionals of America, the basketball and baseball team, and he was a constant supporter of all upper school activities and events. He is a good-natured spirit and provides support to his friends and classmates. He plans to study at Illinois State University. Reese Jenkins. We can always expect an interesting comment from Ethan with his dry sense of humor. He has the ability to take away the tensions in classes and the stresses of his classmates. Enjoyable to watch on stage in his plays, he recently impressed us with his ability to direct his peers, taking the role of director for the student-led production this spring. Ethan is a reliable anchor for any club, performance, or activity. A strong debater who uses humor and sharp critical thinking skills. He plans to study environmental science at Loyola University. Ethan Zen Jajorian. Ireland is a great listener who is always kind and approachable. You can count on her to make amazing playlists and capture unforgettable moments in her photography skills. She is a very conscientious student who always wants to put her best foot forward. And although she claims that she isn't a type A personality, anyone who has seen her multicolor-coded notes might argue differently. She especially will be missed by our journalism clubs and by her many lower school friends who she has cared for at ABC after school. She plans to study environmental science at Marquette University, Ireland Lawrence. In all that she does, Maya stands out. From her stage presence to her original compositions to her incredible outfits, Maya's determination, charisma, and leadership make her a force to be reckoned with. Her personal and inspiring songs bring advocacy to today's issues. Her tireless artistry and confidence in sharing her work with the world has been much appreciated and won't soon be forgotten. She plans to study at the Clive Davis Institute of Recorded Music at New York University. Maya Cherie Oceana Malamba Lopez. known to her friends and teachers as an honest, caring person, always eager to help those she cares about. Amaya has also made a huge impact on student life via the girls' basketball team. She graduates as our number two all-time leading scorer and holder of the single season record, points record, leading the Warriors into the playoffs and earning an All-State recognition. Amaya plans to study at Howard University. Amaya Ulani McLaughlin. A naturally intelligent young man with a keen intellectual curiosity, Carter is an awesome learner about the things that he is most interested in. His understated confidence and plain spokenness made him a valuable contributor on the baseball and golf teams, the Model UN, and the Business Professionals of America. Today, Carter was here at 7:59 a.m. He plans to study finance at Loyola University Chicago, Carter Middleton. Eli's talents are broad and unique. Whatever the activity, ceramics, basketball, skateboarding, he is always smiling and he is fully present in the moment. He loves to participate in any discussion, often adding thought-provoking or humorous comments. He especially enjoys a good debate, whether it is serious for a history class or pleading his case to teachers or game officials. Frequently hilarious, he always seems to find a blend of humor that is also respectful and inclusive. He plans to study at Morehouse College. Elijah Winton Taylor Moss. Although Ayana joined us for her senior year, it seems like she has always been a part of MPA. She helped bring the STEP Club to life and even pursued this with her passion project to bring STEP to our own MPA lower school students. Ayana is enthusiastic and is such a great supporter of her peers, cheering them on in dance, athletics, and in the classroom. She always greets you with a smile. Her love for music really shined when she developed her own radio persona and show this year. We are so glad she joined us for her final 2 years, as even in that short time, she has made such a positive impact. She plans to study at Chicago State University. Ayana Amani Nelson. Although he has not even started law school yet, Tim has been practicing his negotiation skills for quite some time. He is an incredible debater no matter the venue. Not even in the heat of debate is he well-spoken, polite, and always has his research thoughtfully prepared. Tim has high expectations for himself and is determined to accomplish his goals. As co-founder of our chapter with the Business Professionals of America and as a steady supporter of fundraising for cancer research, he continuously demonstrates a commitment to his passions. He brings every day a sincerity and a unique sense of humor. He plans to study at Loyola University. Timothy Prendergast Rooney. never one to seek attention, Manny's quiet presence is noticed nevertheless. From his hidden talents with computers, his quiet intelligence, and his strong moral backbone. He uses these talents quietly and is known for his willingness to be there to help out anyone for any reason. A valuable contributor on the basketball team, he also was instrumental in the growth of our Business Professionals of America chapter. Dedicated and kind-hearted, his work ethic helped him earn a four-year full-ride college scholarship. He plans to study at the University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign, Emmanuel Sapong. Known fondly by his classmates as Little Genius, Tony was their pick as most likely to win a Nobel Prize. We'll just have to figure out what discipline he'll focus on. He was a driving force behind the math team finishing 10th in the state, and he also placed third in the state in physics as an individual. We also will remember his admirable love of the MPA experience. As in his quiet way, he was a fierce school supporter with spirit and MPA pride. He plans to study at Lehigh University, Ni Yung Tang. A master at mobile video games, Will brought an intelligence, a work ethic, and a deep sense of humor to the classroom and his involvement in all aspects of student life. On the math and academic challenge teams, he earned 2 first place medals, including a second place individual finish in physics. He plans to study at the University of Washington, Kinsey Way. William is an incredibly hard-working student who has a strong commitment to doing well in school. Although he can't appear to be quiet, his classmates and teachers know about a sense of humor and a talkative streak that can come out in the right environment. Whether on the math team or in his work toward fitness and nutrition, he typically focuses on his pursuits with a relaxed calm and a level head. He plans to study at the University of California at Santa Barbara, Tong Kei Yong. Julie pays attention to details. First, she has several handwriting fonts that she uses for different occasions or moods, even on homework assignments. Every teacher will tell you her notes are amazing. Just as her handwriting needs to match the occasion, so too do her outfits. She pays attention to fashion and shows her style every non-uniform chance she can get, and some uniform chances. Beyond clothes, she also has an amazing makeup skill. She orders special palettes, watches videos, and practices her techniques, as any artist will. Generous and caring, she will share talents with anyone who wants that special look or just needs someone to listen. She plans to study creative writing at Columbia College Chicago, Juliana Ray Zygmunt. Jimena is an individual who takes full advantage of every opportunity presented to her. She has participated in all aspects of student life during her upper school experience, from sports in the theater to diversity council, service council, and too many other organizations to name. Throughout, she has consistently pushed herself to become a better person. She does not see anything as impossible, rather a chance to be met and conquered. We will miss her kindness and her compassion, her authenticity and her dedication to sharing her culture, including her bachata dances that always were a highlight at Dance for Life. She has earned a four-year full-ride scholarship to study biology at the University of Michigan. Hamina Zuleha. Coming. Our new graduates will leave first to receive their guests around the semicircle at Jonesville, so you can stay seated until our graduates process. Thank you.